In this short video about SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard, we're going to look at the user interface. We'll take a look at the preview, file card and bill of material information, but also look at the contains information and where used. The interface in SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard makes it really easy for both SOLIDWORKS and non-SOLIDWORKS users to have access to data when they need it. When I browse into SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard, it gives me this Windows Explorer style interface where we can define what columns of metadata are displayed based on the user or group of users logging into PDM. When I browse into a file, I can get full preview support for an assembly without the need for opening this inside of SOLIDWORKS. As this uses eDrawings to view the file, I have all of the common commands that we typically see in eDrawings, where we can jump between different views, we can animate the views, I can start to hide and show components, and I also have the ability to measure between entities, which is really useful. We have the file card information that displays metadata, so this information is applicable for the particular file that I have selected. And these data cards can be customized to suit the key information that you want to use and search upon inside of SOLIDWORKS PDM. We also have the ability to view the bill of materials inside of PDM. And the metadata that is displayed when we view a bill of materials again can be customized to suit the user's role within the business. So we're not overloading them with metadata, we're only presenting them with metadata that is applicable for their job role. We also have some great tools in that we can compare versions of bills and materials. So we can see that this component here was added in version 2. And this component has been deleted in version 2. So we can compare one version of a bill of material to another. And the bill of material tab also enables us to focus on just a particular assembly configuration. The contains list shows us every file associated with an assembly, whether it's used on a particular assembly configuration or not. We also have the ability to include where files are located in PDM, but even without the found in column of information, we can simply right click on a file, browse to that file, and it will take us immediately to that file without the need for knowing where that component is. We also have the ability to click on the where used information, so very quickly and easily we can see where components have been used between iterations of a design. So we can see version 1 of this component hasn't been used anywhere, but when we look at version 2, it's used on this top level assembly. So SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard makes it really easy for both SOLIDWORKS and non-SOLIDWORKS users to gain access to the information when they need it.